All right, everybody, thanks for coming back to watch this second video. And I'm going to address an email that I get. I get emails all the time, and I like to take time to address them. And because it tends to get lengthy, I wanted to go ahead and do it in separate videos. So I'll just read to you, you know, it's kind of a rant, but I want to talk about it because this is a rant a lot of people have, and it leads to a lot of confusion in places. And it talks about some personal information here, but then it says, I'm curious why so many of these doctors don't take insurance. Well, I'm going to take this step by step. First off, the medical marijuana program does not have to be accommodated by insurance. It was written specifically for that purpose. The language was written so that it wouldn't have to be and that the insurance companies wouldn't get involved. And it says, I mean, you're not charging for the referral. You just charge for the office visit as a general practitioner or whatever. And then, in course of the visit, discuss and sign off if it's appropriate. Well, to make sure that the person who emailed this and understands, we're not the doctor. And we do charge like a referral service, but our referral service basically includes the notary, the fingerprint, and everything set up in your doctor's folder so that when you go there, it's like they're already expecting you. So it's not that we're the doctors, and it's not that our MCCMV, our charity, doesn't take in service fees to help you. We just take in a much smaller service fee than everybody else out there. And we give our clients a lot more when they meet the qualifying criteria for us to be able to help them. It's that simple. And then the email goes on, it says, the cash only thing makes me more uncomfortable, I think, because it makes me feel like a kickback instead of a legitimate medical service. Well, I can tell you this, up to this day, right now, everybody knows, MCCNV has not received a single kickback other than my actual paperwork was signed at no charge for the services that I do by my doctor. So even though we referred hundreds and hundreds of patients out there to doctors, we have yet to receive a kickback from any doctor. So I wanted to make sure that that is completely clear. At this time, we have not received not even a donation. We have not received a single kickback from any doctor, no donation, nothing. The only thing I have received is I received a $150 value by basically signing off on my form. So I wanted to address that. So it is a legitimate medical service. It's just because insurance doesn't have to be accepted in this, that's the reason for the cash only. If you'll, you know, basically if you think about it, the state, they'll take a personal check, but it's a cash only. They don't take any form of insurance or it's, and it doesn't take $200 to, yeah, okay, we'll talk about that in another video. We'll stick to the email. And it says, I'm sure there are reasons, which I just gave. It says, it's just the initial way it comes across. And trust me, I know how it comes across. Kind of like when I saw the doctor that I saw this week, and he said, well, I don't write recommendations, but he gave me the card of someone to contact who would help me through the process. And said to tell him that Dr. X sent me, which made me feel like it's a referral kickback program. Once again, a lot of doctors, they're trying to work to get their reputation as being people who help the patients that legitimately qualify. So it's a giant gray cloud, and everybody's trying to do their best they can to walk within the shadows. We shouldn't have to, but a lot of people are afraid to fight. They don't want to have that fight. That was part from that first video, why we need to ask these questions and get loud about it. And it also addresses another issue about how doctors refer people to us when we can't sign the form. And it saddens me greatly when people's doctors refer them to people that aren't doctors for your medical treatment. Shouldn't they go back and get some continuing medical education about, you know, advancements in their field or something like that? Trust me, I hear the frustrations. It's like I was telling an associate yesterday. I am part of the greatest choir the world has ever listened to. When we join together, we sing the most beautiful melodies the world can ever imagine. However, the hardest part of this choir, or any other choir for that matter, high school, middle school, any choir, is getting people to join. Because the fact of the matter is this, any choir doesn't have a glamour, you know, the Harlem Boys Choir. when you see them on TV before they went defunct, everyone's like, wow, they're awesome. I'm glad that they're around, kind of. And it's like, well, how do you get people into the choir? Oh, I don't want to be in the choir. That's not manly. Or I got better thoughts. Forget that. The cannabis choir is where it's at. And we need to sing louder and louder and louder. And I don't know why it's so hard to get people to want to stand up and be in this choir and be willing to speak. But more and more people are stepping forward. The choir is getting bigger and bigger every day. And we have to get bigger and louder and bigger and louder and get our song unified. It's that simple. It's a plant and needs to be legalized. We all know that. However, within the state of Nevada and within the legal bounds that exist right now, medical marijuana patients have rights. We have the right. So since that's where we're at in Nevada, then we need to be loud together for the rights. Let's get what the Constitution was supposed to give these people back in 2001. Let's get that right so that when we move forward with the other steps that might happen in the future in regards to cannabis, it won't step all over the backs of the patients and push us to the back burner where we continue to sit, and we've been sitting for 10 years already. It's that simple. Let's get right what's been wrong since day one before we start piling more and more wrongs on top of it. It's that simple. All right? Thank you for watching this video. Hopefully the person who sent that email, you're able to kind of figure out whose email it is, so on and so forth. And if you watch, we're going to go ahead and finish this one up. We got another one coming right after this. All right, everybody. Hopefully you'll stick around and watch the next one. And then we got one after that, and we might just keep going. We'll see how far this Monday takes us. It's time to get to work. We can't let it go on. Every day that we ignore it is another day that we let others win. That ignorance overcomes intelligence, and we can't let it happen anymore. Ignorance cannot overcome intelligence. We must educate and inform, and we must continue to do so. Please help. Please help in any way that you can. Whether it be watching these videos, telling others to watch about them, whether it be financial support for our charity, whatever it may be, continue to watch. Thank you so much. We have another video coming, another email to address, and then the article, of course. We'll see you back with another one in a few minutes.